What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Dylan Snyder, real estate agent here in Jupiter, Florida. And today, I'm gonna talk about the pros and the cons of living in Jupiter. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button below and hit the bell to be notified of any new videos we have coming up. We will be posting weekly videos and helpful information on living in Jupiter and the surrounding areas. That phone number that you see below there, you can call, text anytime. My wife loves midnight text messages, so don't hesitate. Anyways, that number below, feel free to use it. Give me a call or text anytime. Let's start off with some of the pros. The economy here is absolutely just booming right now. It's a huge science area. We have Scripps Research Institute, who is also located in La Jolla, California. Brought in a ton of jobs, and we also have Max Planck. They do research for treatments for cancer. Max Planck brought in also a ton of jobs into the Jupiter area. They're located right in the Abacoa area. Carrier was also another company, formerly United Technologies, and again, bringing in a ton of jobs for the area. So huge, huge science area. And not to mention, the fishing industry here is on fire. You know, we have fresh fish coming in every day to these restaurants. Right now, I'm in one of our newer spots in the Jupiter Inlet District, Lucky Shucks, which is Joe Namath's new addition to the area. And, you know, again, so the fishing industry is just booming. Hospitality as well. I have personally an Airbnb property, and it is booked year round. The hotels in the area, if you're looking for great hotels, feel free to call me. I'm happy to give recommendations. But the hotels in the area, top notch, you know, just really, really busy because it's a big second home market here. Anything that's having to do with hospitality or travel, tourism, it's really doing well. So there's no lack of amazing things to do here in Jupiter, and mostly outdoors. So as you can see here, I'm in front of the Jupiter Lighthouse. Approach over here is the Jupiter Inlet, and the boating here is absolutely top notch. So boating, fishing, you know, anything outdoors having to do with the water, wakeboarding, kite surfing, surfing. You know, Jupiter is kind of a small beach town, but very, very active as well. Some of our local festivals, arts festivals, you know, there's a lot of art here, and so we have Art Fest by the Sea, which is a strip of Ocean Avenue, and they close it off. You know, tons of people come from all over the world with their art and sell art during that weekend. Artie Gras as well in Abacoa. Abacoa is the home of the Marlins and Cardinals spring training facility, so that's a really hot spot. Downtown Jupiter is actually being developed right now, which is where we are. So downtown Jupiter, we really don't have any walkable areas until recently. And once this is developed, this will be our walkable kind of downtown. But no lack of things to do here in Jupiter, especially when it comes to the outdoors. So what I loved when I moved to this area is no matter where you are in Jupiter, even if you go out to the equestrian area in Jupiter Farms, everything is super convenient. If you're in Jupiter Farms, which is west of 95, basically you're still like 12 minutes away from the beach, you know, kind of depending on where you are. You know, if you're a little bit south in Jupiter, you know, there's roads that you can take as shortcuts and just kind of cut around and again, get to beaches super easily. You can get to restaurants, shopping, no matter where you are. What I tell clients when they come into town, everything's 10 minutes. Everything's 10 minutes. So super convenient and accessible. So a little bit about demographic here in Jupiter. The average age is 46 years old. So it's definitely a younger, more trendy area. A lot of young families, a lot of neighborhoods that attract young families with, you know, kind of amenities that have a lot of kid-friendly activities. However, even if you're an empty nester or if you're retired, there's definitely plenty of things to do and you're not gonna feel out of place. So Jupiter really has something for everybody. The next pro on living here are the pet-friendly beaches. You know, there's a long strip of beach going from Juno Beach all the way up to Jupiter Inlet area, basically, where you can bring your dogs, and you're supposed to be on a leash, but you bring your dogs, always have to clean up after them. In addition, there's no metered parking along this stretch of beaches. So a lot of areas down south in Boca or Del Rey, you have to have a club pass and you have to pay an annual fee, or you have to pay a meter, and, you know, and so here, there's open parking, even in the busiest time of year, you can still find a spot. A lot of preserve areas, a lot of parks, which I love. So the next really cool thing about this area is you're not allowed to have commercial signs over 10 feet in the air, which really keeps our skyline nice and clean. If you go down south and go down to Miami, you'll notice that, you know, there's a Home Depot sign soaring up in the air like 50 feet. And so here, you'll drive down Indian Town Road, which is our main artery here in Jupiter, and you'll notice that the signs are not above 10 feet, even if it's a gas station, Walmart, Home Depot. Home Depot looks like a Key West style commercial building. So everything's very well manicured, beautiful architecture, and no signs above 10 feet. So the next positive is all of the newer communities in this area that you really have to choose from. You know, there's definitely plenty of older as well, but most of the land has been bought up by developers. There's a lot of beautiful new developments that offer tons of amenities, all the latest hurricane codes, so no lack of newer communities to choose from when looking to move to the area. So this area has also been a hot spot for local celebs. You have Michael Jordan, Tiger Woods, Celine Dion, Olivia Newton-John, definitely no lack of celebrities, and it's not uncommon to go to a place like Belay, which I was there last week, and have Ricky Fowler sit down right next to you. So another pro, if you're into golf, would be that there is no lack of amazing golf courses. You have 16 courses in Jupiter alone. You have 70 other courses within 20 miles, and 9 of which are actually public courses. So again, if you're into golf, plenty of options. If you wanted to look in a club community where you have equity memberships and amenities, or if you wanted to check out a public course that we have, definitely something for everybody. So another thing that I liked about this area was that there are no restaurants that are directly on the beach, which keeps our beaches nice and clean. You're not gonna walk down the beach and find cigarette butts and beer bottles and, you know, it's just not that kind of vibe here. So there's one restaurant that's just off the beach. It's on Beachside, Loggerhead Cafe. It's a great breakfast spot. Go grab some pancakes, some eggs, and take a nice morning stroll on the beach. But otherwise, there's no lack of restaurant options in the rest of the area here. So we are in a newly developed Jupiter Inlet District, which they just added about 4 new restaurants here. This is gonna be our downtown area. But scattered throughout Jupiter, it's mostly family-owned restaurants, fresh seafood, amazing steak, definitely no lack of great places to eat. So we're sitting out here on the Jupiter Inlet, and another thing that I love about this area is you got crystal clear blue water. We're super close to the Gulf Stream, which keeps our waters flowing here. And you drive down, you're in a boat, you're going down the Jupiter Inlet, or going down the Loxahatchee River, and you could just see all the way to the bottom. So go to the beaches, it's nice blue water, and look at this. This is just an absolutely amazing day that we're out here shooting this video today. You'll notice if you're looking around to move to the area that there's not a lot of gated communities here, and there's a reason for that, and that's because of our low crime rate here. If you're looking to get stabbed, you really have to travel far distance. We're a very safe community. Some of our best communities don't have gates, and you know, you can pretty much walk around all of Jupiter and not have to put your hand over your pocket. So let's face it, guys, Jupiter's not known for amazing schools, right? So, but Jupiter, however, is known for pretty good A-rated public schools. So if you're looking into the public school system, Jupiter High School is one of the top rated schools here in Florida and in Palm Beach County. Also some amazing elementary and middle schools, and there's plenty of great private schools around as well. So that would be a pro as far as living in Jupiter. I guess you can kind of put it into the con category as well if you're used to schools that are up in Westchester County, best schools in the country. So, but Jupiter schools are not shabby. So the next pro is gonna be flying in and commuting. Commuting to Jupiter and commuting to Palm Beach is super easy. So the airport is on the smaller side, it's an international airport, and especially if you're coming from the Northeast, super easy direct flights back and forth. You're to Jupiter in 20 minutes, space 15, 20 minutes, door to door. So super, super convenient. Now, if you're going to Stewart or Boca, you know, you're probably looking at closer to like 30, 45 minutes from the airport to your front door. So if you're into arts, we do have the Jupiter Malztheater, which is nearby. They're doing a major renovation right now. They have some great shows there, Broadway shows. And then if you're looking to go to the Kravitz Center, Kravitz Center is a huge theater, and that's about 20 minutes south in West Palm Beach, downtown West Palm. So no lack of entertainment, also very accessible to kind of Miami and things like that if you're looking to go even further south, but definitely no lack of theater and arts. So that's kind of it for the pros. However, I could keep going on and on because there's a ton of positives for living here. I really struggled to come up with the cons. We're gonna dive into them a little bit here in a minute, but I really struggled to come up with some things that I didn't like about the area. The cost of living here in Jupiter, I guess, would be a little bit of a con. Cost of living is probably a little higher than the national average. So we're about 9.9% higher. That's directly related to mostly like the tourism, the housing market. You know, housing is a little bit more pricey here, taxes, property taxes. However, there are no state income taxes. Our property taxes are still a little bit higher. If you're looking for more info on cost of living in Jupiter, you can go back and watch my video on cost of living in Jupiter. That's right here or up here somewhere. Another one on the list would be growth. As with any hot town, there comes growth. And we have herds of folks moving here from the Northeast. Jupiter is getting a little bit busy on Indian Town Road. So if you don't time it properly, Indian Town Road does tend to get a little congested. However, as I went into in some of my pros, there are plenty of alternative routes that you can take to avoid Indian Town Road. If you go up on this map and you go up to Center Street and you cut over, you can cut around, or you go down south of Indian Town and you take Tony Penna and you go across. So there's a couple alternatives. The bridges, the railroad, the tracks, the train. You can, if you want to get really strategic, you can time those. The bridges go up every half hour. So, you know, if you time it right, you can skip the bridge and really avoid even more traffic. So next on the list, we live in the tropics. And with that comes unpredictable weather that some days it'll be raining on one side of the street and the other side of the street will be perfectly sunny. Sometimes can be a little bit scary. You know, we do have hurricanes coming through. Our hurricane season stretches from, you know, summertime up until about November. You know, it's the tropics, so anything can happen. However, I will tell you, the news always makes it look way worse than it really is. I've gone through numerous hurricanes, and I've actually been outside walking my dog in hurricanes, and it really hasn't been that bad. Unless we get a Category 5, 4 or 5 storm, you know, it's usually easy to kind of get through these and little damage afterwards, hopefully. The summers, they're hot. If you don't like the heat, it might not be for you. So me personally, I prefer cool weather. This time of year, we're filming this right now at the end of February, and it's like 75 degrees outside, sunny. You can't beat this weather. So, but summer times are brutal. So if you're looking to avoid the heat, maybe buy a winter home here and keep your home up north and travel back and forth like a lot of our clients do. So next on the con list, in my opinion, and I think I have a really good opinion, the drivers in Florida are horrendous. So a while back, I actually had a motorcycle and enjoyed, you know, riding it down. We don't really have scenic roads, but the drivers here just scared the crap out of me. So got rid of the bike, didn't want to kill myself, still love bikes, but the drivers in Florida, you know, are a little questionable. So I'm not sure where that law comes into place where they have to go get retested, because I think half of these people can't even see. The next thing that kind of bothered me about this area, not a huge deal, but if you have traveled a little bit over the west coast of Florida, Sarasota, Naples, you know, those areas, Marco Island, you'll notice that the beach and the sand there is really soft, white sugar sand. Come over here to the east coast, although we have the blue, crystal clear water, the sand is kind of shelly and crunchy and not very smooth on your feet. So that was another thing that just I didn't really care for. Not a huge deal again, but I had to come up with a list of cons, and that's on my list. So next on the list, kind of a pro and a con, if you ask me, it's a little bit slow here as far as nightlife in Jupiter. So, you know, if you're looking to go clubbing and have a late night, come home at 5 in the morning, this is really not the spot for you. However, you can drive 20 minutes and go down to West Palm and, you know, have a super late night, get an Uber back. So very convenient and accessible once again. You know, Jupiter is more of a laid back, town. We have plenty of bars and restaurants on the beach. Typically they close down at about 2 a.m. is about average. Next on the con list is going to be deep water dockage. So if you have a really big boat, 70 plus feet, and you're drawing 5 feet plus, it's difficult to find dockage that will accommodate. Anything up on the Loxahatchee River, the water tends to be a little bit more shallow, great for outboards. You know, anything with a bigger boat, we gotta do a little bit of searching, which I'm very good at. By the way, I am a local agent and I do that. Yeah, bigger boats are just a little more challenging. So that wraps it up for the pros and cons of living in Jupiter. Appreciate you watching. Don't forget to hit the bell below to be notified of any new videos we have coming up. We will be doing weekly videos on living in Jupiter and the surrounding areas. And my phone number right there below. My wife, remember, loves those late night texts, so feel free to text, call, anytime. Just kidding, don't get me in trouble. Also, I'm a local agent. I've been in the business here for 20 years. Anything real estate related, if you're looking to move to the area or have questions on the area, feel free to reach out to me via text or in the comments below. I do love comments. If you have ideas on videos that you'd love to see coming, please put them in the comments and I'll make sure that I put them out. Thanks for watching, guys.